Hello, everybody, and welcome here. NBC Sports bringing you live flag-to-flag coverage of the Mud Summer Nationals. Here is Heat number one, 10 laps, and Heat number one. This Heat this season is known as the Rookie Heat. So if you've been in the Sportsman Series for under a year or are a rookie, a year in Sportsman or a rookie, you are in this race. On the pole, Scott Roush. Then it is Eli Bright. Then it is Isaiah Monaco, JT Bryant, JT Hanley, Cole Deaver, Tim Brooks Jr., Alan Matthews, Isaac Jacob, Jeff Bright, Eric Monaco, Eric Hayden, Alex Hawkins, Annie Thomas, Matt Haas, TJ Hanley, Al Legacy, Nick Kennedy, Eric Rodriguez, Tayon Kennedy, and Derek Edison. There's 21 cars in this race that are either 1 year in or not have never raced in the Sportsman Series. As the command has been given, the engines are fired here at Eldora Speedway. The fans have been waiting. They are so happy that the new Gen 2 cars are here at Eldora. Scott Roush is going to bring us through turn number 3. And he's going to gun it on the start because he knows he wants to make it into the Mud Summer National. And the green flag is out. And we are underway. If you're new to the series, only the top 10 make it into the Mud Summer Nationals. So they were 3 wide in the turn number 1. Isaiah Monaco to the inside of Scott Roush, sliding up the hill. As you can see, this is the race for the rookies and the guys who have never raced ever in the Mud Summer Nationals. And you can see there's a guy who has that finished almost second last season. Isaac Jekyll is putting all the knowledge of the Mud Summer National into this race, the 55 sideways, and look at Jacob move. He is all the way to almost a second position. Third place is Isaac Jacob in the 51. Scott Roush sliding around on the high side. Here comes Matt Haas in the battle. Third place now belongs to Isaac Jacob in the number 51. Last season, he drove the 40 for Guns Motorsports. He's in the 51 for Guns Motorsports. Rookie of the Year winner right here. So he knows how to get the job done. Eric Hayden sliding up the hill. If you don't remember the rules, like I said, only the top 10 make it in. And a guy who didn't even race that race last season, Eric Rodriguez, second place finisher in Rookie of the Year, sitting in eighth, marching his way through the field as Isaiah Monaco is trying to get away from Cole Deaver. As both Monster Energy cars look really stout in the early going. Currently the car in 10th is Al Legacy. This was the car that won the Mud Summer National last season. Drops to 11th place. The 10 car of Alan Matthews is now in the transfer spot. JT Bryant's going to try to get in here. This is all right here is the battle for the transfer spot. 11 cars will go to the LCQ from this event. Who's in 10th right now? I think it's the one car of Eli Bright. It is. JT Bryant last season tried to help his teammate Kelly Boston last season. Drove it in the final corner and did not make the show. He missed the show because he helped his teammate in Heat 1. He's got a teammate right behind him in Heat 2. Sliding around. Alan Matthews, is he about to lose that transfer spot on the white flag? Coming to the white flag. Here it is. White flag's out. Who's going to make the Mud Summer National? Heat number one. It's going to be a drag race right here. Looks like Isaiah Thomas might win. It's going to be door to door. JT Bryant, if he doesn't get loose, is going to make it in via the heats. As Alan Matthews will now go to the LCQ. Hernandez Motorsports has got a car in the LCQ last season. Every one of their cars went to the LCQ. Cars joining him in the LCQ is Alex Hawkins, Alex Hayden, Nick Kennedy, Eric Monaco, Scott Roush, Annie Thomas, JT Hanley. So these are all the cars going to the LCQ. Matthews, Hawkins, Hayden, Monaco, Kennedy, Edison, Thomas, Roush, Lagacy, JT Hanley, and Jeff Bright are all going to the LCQ. So up next is going to be the big dogs, the veteran heat. As the command has already been given. Heat number two, the veteran heat, Brandon Guns on the pole. Then it is Robert Pollard, Stephen Pollard, DJ Curtis running the new 33 for Curtis Harvick Incorporated, KHI. Then you have the two Roush Couturiers, Orion Swan and Zachary Fitzwater. Then you have Sam Curtis, John Gilbert, the two-time Midsummer National winner. Then you have Sasuli, Joey Murphy. Then you have the two Hernandez Motorsports, the Diaz and Hernandez. The green flag is out, and we are underway for Heat 2 of the Midsummer Nationals. And we're almost four wide back here for second spot. Last season, when they were talking about heats, they said the season before they did it numerically. This season, they said, we want to do it by veterans. We want to do it by rookies. Because we know the veteran guys are going to put on a show because they want to make it in. They know how big this event is. The rookies kind of don't. And we kind of seen that looking in the back. Nine cars go to the LCQ in this heat. Look at DJ up against the wall. Zachary Fitzwater. Emmanuel Harnett. These guys know what it means to race in the Midsummer Nationals. Stephen Pollard. You could have Joey Murphy. Look, Joey Murphy every season has been the car that just ekes his way in barely in his heat. Now he's in the back. John Gilbert, two-time winner. The only Midsummer National here this season is sitting in the back in that Penske Dodge. Look at this, three and four wide. Battling for a transfer position because you know you got to make it in. Brandon Guns is gone. He is pulling away as Sam Curtis is going to try to reel him in. Him and Ryan Swan. Currently in the transfer spot is Luis Hernandez, and here comes Joey Murphy. Joey Murphy, the last two seasons that he has had to race his way in the Midsummer National, he's made the last lap pass. Here comes Robert Pollard as Luis Hernandez got up out of the groove. Got loose. Here comes the 47's gonna have to lock it up. He started sliding, so's Murphy. Two laps to go. Three to go, excuse me. Brandon Guns has put a big gap on Sam Curtis. Don't need to be watching that battle. We gotta watch this 14 car. White flag, or two to go, excuse me. Sorry, we're jumping the gun here. Is Joey Murphy making it? Is Sasuli making it? Who's going to make this Midsummer National? Is Robert Pollard going to try something? White flag. Murphy going to make the move. He's going to know he wants to be in. He's going to slide the knife. And it looks like for the second season in a row, Hernandez Motorsports is going to have two all their cars into LCQ. Look at this. Battle for the final position. Sasuli. It's going to keep a spot. And Robert Pollard is going to the LCQ along with Oreo Pollard, David Diaz, Luis Hernandez, Tanner Guns, Stephen Pollard, season one champion, and John Gilbert, and Steve Pollard with a lot of back end damage. So something has happened to Steve Pollard. Ooh. He just get loose. Oh, he dove it in deep and it just stepped out on him. And oh no, DJ Curtis. Also, DJ Curtis missed that race last season. So cars in the season's Midsummer National: Brandon Guns, Ryan Swan, Sam Curtis, Zachary Fitzwater, Cody Lamas, Rick Johnson, Emmanuel Harnett, Ash Curtis, Joey Murphy, and Joshua Sasuli. Cars going to the LCQ. Robert Pollard, Oreo Pollard, David Diaz, Luis Hernandez, Tanner Guns, Stephen Pollard, John Gilbert, DJ Curtis, and Steve Pollard all going to the LCQ. So we will get your LCQ lineup right now, and they will be on the track for 20 laps here at Eldora. As the command has been given for the LCQ. On the polls, DJ Curtis and his Sky Roush. Then it is Oreo Pollard, Luis Hernandez, Nick Kennedy, Tanner Guns, Robert Pollard, JT Hanley. Or is that TJ? I think that's JT. Then it's Robert. Then it is Jeff Bright, Derek Edison, Steve Pollard, Eric Monaco, John Gilbert, Eddie Thomas, Al Lagasse, Alan Matthews, Stephen Pollard, David Diaz, Eric Hayden, and Alex Hawkins. Green flag is out. 20 laps for the LCQ. Who will make it into the Mud Summer Nationals? This is a big question. This is a question that's been on everyone's mind with these Gen 2 cars. Would it change how the Mud Summer Nationals are played and who is good? I think it has. John Gilbert, the two-time winner, barely made it through the field. And I think we have more rookies this season that made it. We have a ton of veterans in the LCQ. And it's more, I think it's morely because some of the younger guys they have not raced on the big old track with the old car. The old car was more of a dirt car. It had a front valence. It didn't have a splitter. These guys have had to raise the splitters up so it wouldn't dig. John Gilbert's car, I don't know if you're noticing it right now, it's just digging. And then they made the 17 the same setup as last season. That's the car that John Gilbert won with without Lagasse in it. So they don't know what to do with that car. Only the top 10 get in from the LCQ. So his cars are pulling away at battling. Right now, currently in 10th spot, is Alan Matthews. Actually, he probably just lost that spot to the 83. And the 87 now of Annie Thomas is in the transfer spot. All right, now, if you're in the top five, you're safe. You just ride around. If you're back here, Alan Matthews, Annie Thomas, Tanner Guns level, you're trying to race hard, and you know you have to. Guys like Luis Hernandez. Luis Hernandez has never missed the Mud Summer National. He's been here at all three of them. David Diaz missed the Mud Summer Nationals his first ever season. Last season, he said he vowed to never miss it again. Now he's in trouble. He might miss this race. John Gilbert, the two-time winner of this event, went back-to-back, Season 2 and Season 3 winner, might not make the Season 4 Mud Summer National. Lagasse, though, trying to get out of here. Robert Steve Pollard right now is in the transfer spot. Think about a Mud Summer National without Luis Hernandez. Think about one without John Gilbert. In all honesty, it's hard to think about. Those guys have been in this event every season. Since the inception, before we even had heats, when it was just a one-race event, and a battle for the transfer spot now three wide, this is going to help the 5, the 12. Oh, the 17 really not clear. The 30 car is to a backup car. Remember, he crashed at the end of his heat. At the end of the heat, too. 17 right now is in. And this is the car that won the event last season. Well, not the car, but it was the same team. All right, now you got these two guys racing on the outside trying to look in. David Diaz just said his car is too tight to sling, so David Diaz might be going home. Currently now, I think Tanner Guns just put himself into the Mud Summer National with that pass. Three wide here, Scott Roush. Tanner Guns has now locked himself into the Mud Summer National. And he's pulling away. He's got to pull away from the 87. Actually, he's going to try to pass the 83. To try to make himself even more safe. That's going to put Season 1 champion and the only champion in the field. And the caution is now out. As Luis Hernandez and Steve Pollard have crashed. the new rule for the series is we will have green white checkers once again. Last season we did not have green white checkers. This season we will have green white checkers. So it looks like if they can get the 30 and the 5 fixed, they better hurry because we're going to have a green white checker. Let's see what happened to them to bring out the first caution of the Midsummer National night. And it looks like the 30 just gets in the back of the 5 and then gets into John Gilbert. So John Gilbert might have some damage. And then just look at the 5, drove it up the hill to get some payback. Also looks like the 29 has got some damage as well. So we will get you to the restart here. It's going to be a green white checker, guys. So right now, is anyone safe? Right now, the 10th place car, Stephen Pollard, is he safe in making it? We will find out in just a moment. Pace car's pulling in 2 laps. Green white checker. Louise and Robert Pollard deep in the field. Can they make it all the way up? Can they make 10 spots up in a lap? Green flag. 2 laps of racing to go. In the LCQ. Look at Eric Monaco. He wants to win this under Oreo Pollard. Let's get you to the back of the field. Look at the flying through the field. Who's in the transfer spot right now? It's the 10 of Matthews. Not everybody can make it. They're 3 and 4 wide. Who's going to get in the Midsummer National? Is it Scott Roush? Is it Hayden? Is it David Diaz? Who's in? Alex Hawkins will make it in. And all 3 Hernandez Motorsports machines miss the Midsummer National. John Gilbert, the defending winner of the event, will also miss. The back-to-back winner will miss the Midsummer National. Eric Monaco, Oreo Pollard, Derek Edison, Robert Pollard, Tanner Guns, Nick Kennedy, Annie Thomas, DJ Curtis, Scott Roush, and Alex Hawkins will all make the Midsummer National. Cars that will be going home. Eric Hayden, Alan Matthews, David Diaz, Al Agassi, Luis Hernandez, Stephen Pollard, Steve Pollard, John Gilbert, Jeff Bright, and JT Hanley. Luis Hernandez just not happy on the radio. Not happy at all. So we will get ready for now for the Midsummer Nationals. Hello everybody, NBC Sports, and we are live here at Eldora Speedway from Rossburg, Ohio, with the Midsummer National, the 4th annual, on the pole in the number 4, Red Bull Toyota, Oreo Pollard. The engines are getting fired, but they're going to sit there for a little bit as that these engines warm up. It is a cool and chilly night. Starting 2nd, though, in the Roush Fenway, Scott's Easy Seed Ford, Scott Roush. Starting 3rd in the Lowe's Cobalt 48, Cody Lamas. Starting in 5th in the 00 Aaron's Toyota, that is Nick Kennedy. Starting in 5th, the number 16, Ford Roush Performance, Zachary Fitzwater. Starting in 7th, in the Kingsford Toyota, Robert Pollard. Starting 8th, in the Motorcraft Quick Lane Ford, Eric Rodriguez. Starting 9th, in the Mack Tools Ford, Ash Curtis. Starting 10th, in the 55 Aaron's Toyota, Tim Brooks Jr. Starting in 11th, in the Weedy Chevrolet Impala, Tanner Guns. Starting 12th, in the number 1 Bass Pro Shop Chevrolet Impala, is Eli Bright. Starting 13th, in the number 62 Pilot Flying J Toyota, T.J. Hanley. And there's the rest of the field of Sam Curtis, Isaac Jekyll, Emmanuel Harnett, Joey Murphy, Joshua Cecily, Richard Johnson, Alex Hawkins, Brandon Guns, Ryan Swan, Derek Edison, Eric Monaco, Isaiah Monaco, Cole Deaver, Annie Thomas, DJ Curtis, Matt Haas, JT Bryant, and Tavon Kennedy coming to the green flag here at Eldora. Fourth annual month Summer Nationals. Fireworks are flying here as the house that Earl built has just got woken up. As Oreo Pollard gonna try to go ahead and pull away. Kind of like what he did in the LCQ. Look at the man sitting in third. Ooh, the 21 got really sideways. Cody Lamas to the back bumper of Oreo Pollard. Luis Hernandez is sitting in the grandstand right now, and along with all his drivers for Hernandez Motorsports. And look at Lamas here battling with Oreo Pollard. Lap 4 of 50. Zachary Fitzwater is there. Eli Bright battling with Rodriguez. A guy we need to watch out for. A guy who almost won this race last season. Isaac Jekyll, who was marching through the field right now. Everybody in this race has never won a Mud Summer National. So we are going to have a different winner this season. Cody Lamas to the point. Oreo Pollard battling with Zachary Fitzwater for second. A lot of people are saying Zachary Fitzwater, it might be his season this season to maybe win the championship. Like Roush. Roush and Yates are putting a lot of power into the 16 car. They're putting a lot of power into the 6, and a lot of power is going into that 21 car. Also, Ash Curtis is getting some of that performance. The only reason they're getting this performance is because Roush and Yates know that these were the Fords that ran the best last season. So a new car, you're going to give it all to your best studs. And that's what happened. It looks like Hendrick, though. Hendrick lost a lot of good talent. And they had to go out and find some guys. Cody Lamas has been the only Hendrick guy to stay since season one in this 40 Dominate. And right now, Cody Lamas showing maybe that Hendrick wasn't planning for Luis Hernandez and those guys to be the lead guy. Maybe they were planning for it to be Lamas as the caution is out, and it's a big one. Isaac Jekyll, Tanner Guns, Two Guns Motorsports Machines, Derek Edison was in the wall a ton as well. So a big crash is just taking place as the cars have caught to the pace car here. 10 of 50. And did not take long for this. And it looks like Alex Hawkins just turns the 11 of Derek Edison. And Edison just going to gun it, try to catch it, gets it to Isaac. And then Tanner Guns, once again, just like last season, had nowhere to go. That's the second season in a row for Tanner Guns. He just had nowhere to go and gets crashed. And the first crash of the Mud Summer National. Let's get you to the green flag. Caution is out still. Lights are still on that nationwide pace car. Down to back into three. Coming in. Coming to the green. Lamas, Fitzwater. Cody got a great start. And we are on 15 of 50. As Cody got a great launch. Look at the 11. Ton of damage. It doesn't matter. Aerodynamics don't matter on a dirt track. Engine power is what matters. And that Gibbs Toyota going to try to march back up as close as he can to the front. Top, and speaking of points, since this is our first points paying race, top 15 once again this season. Get points currently sitting in 15th, walking out of here with 1 point. If the race were to end right now, it is Rick Johnson. Actually, no, it would be Eric Monaco walking out with only 1 point. Get you to the front of the field. Cody Lamas right now would be walking out of this race with 15 if it ended right now. And right now it looks like there's no one to battle with the 48. And speaking of Hendrick, look who's now the second or third. The 24, that's Joshua Cecily. Hendrick kind of got him on a steal. Cecily didn't have a ride for this season. Everyone kind of cast him out. They said, oh, his season one success, it was a fluke. Rick Hendrick said, well, I need somebody to drive that famous 24. Everyone says it's not a championship winning car. Luis Hernandez said it wasn't. Rick Johnson said it wasn't. And now, Joshua Cecilli in that car, is he going to make it a championship winning car? Tim Brooks Jr. last season drove the 51, now moved to the 55. And stepped on board full time for Michael Waltrip Racing, and a caution is out once again as soon as Fitzwater got to him. And this is a big one. Cole Deaver, Emmanuel Harnand is stuck against the wall. Oh, there's a lot of cars with some big time damage. 47, that's Robert Pollard destroyed. Tanner Guns. Scott Roush has got a lot of damage. See what brought out this caution. Lap 20. So 10 laps apart from the first one is the second one. And something happens up here with Emmanuel. Maybe it's on up here a little early. Ooh. Man, something happened with Cole Deaver. He's got a lot of nose damage way before. See what happened. He's going to battle. Ooh, he makes a slight contact. Gets up in the fence. Man, Scott Roush has that thing locked down. Ooh! Oh, man, Scott Roush had that car locked down. And so did Ash Curtis. They stopped. They're like, okay, we have to stop. There's nowhere else for us to go. And I think Emmanuel Harnett really had nowhere to go either. He had no one up on the high side. Ooh. And then, oh, the 47. And then this is where the 78. Then there's 11, the 51, the 31. Emmanuel Harnett took a couple good shots. Luckily, he hopped up out of that race car and ran across the racetrack. Got out of that thing, and he is all right, as this is the new safer era, safer car. I said 31 is going to be a lap down. Get you to the green here. Whew. Big impacts, but this is the era of, as everyone's calling it, the era of the safer car. Is Tanner now going to start on the inside of this 48? So, if you're Fitzwater, you're hoping to get a good start to keep in line. Green flag, and the 24 also got a good start. So, they're all going to get by the... they all need to get by the 31 before turn 1. 24 kind of didn't. And that's going to let Cody kind of pull away a little bit. 51 trying to get... trying to battle. Ooh, the 55 was dead sideways for half the corner. And the 24 faded like a rock. He's dropping back. It's the 43 of Sam Curtis up here. A lot of people said Sam Curtis was, ever since he had his bad crash at Indianapolis where he had a bruised sternum and actually blacked out. He was unconscious. He had to go get a concussion evaluation test. And almost missed a race in season two because of a very violent crash at Indianapolis. Looking like maybe Sam Curtis, new car, maybe he's going to be a stout guy for the Ford camp. Three wide back here. Alex Hawkins going to drive it under Eli Bright and Tim Brooks Jr. Caution flag is back out on the racetrack. Looks like it happened to the 44. The Hendrick test car looks like it had another issue. And yeah, it looks like this time he had help from another Ford. And this one, Scott Roush. And Scott Roush did not let off. So something must have happened a little earlier in the event. Really nothing big has happened. So Cody Lamas right now. Hoping this race can end. He's led every lap in the event right now. They've got the pace car lights off, and pace car's going to pull in here. It's going to be Cody battling with Zachary Fitzwater. Green flag, Fitzwater. This time got an even better start, but he's got to run a little higher than Cody does in turn one. This has opened the door for Eric Rodriguez to maybe slide by the 43. Ooh, the 43 wiggles. I think the 16 cannot wait for a caution where the 31 is not there behind him. Because right now the 16 is bad fast. And now he's got to run Cody back down. DJ Curtis here trying to get up here and score a little bit of points. Alex Hawkins up here running a very good race for that 22 car. It's good to see the 22 car up in the front. John Gilbert's teammate. I heard some scuffing and huffing back here. Don't know if anyone's crashing or not. 15 gonna wiggle a little bit. 5 hour versus Monster. And right now, Zachary Fitzwater is running down Cody Lamas. And now this is what Fitzwater wants to see. We're at 10 to go, so if a caution were to come out, and we got this thing back green, he would just start behind Cody. There would be no car to the inside of Cody. Ooh, this time Cody pulls a little bit away. And there's a crash! Caution is out! Oh, this is all on the front straightaway. These cars are slow. Officials need to be waving this caution quick. And Cody needs to jam the brake. Jam. Cody's all over the brake. So he do. Ooh. These cars have got to get by the pace car. Somebody's smoking up here. It's Tanner Guns. Watch out. Move out of the way. A lot of cars are coming into pit road right now. This could hurt Fitzwater. We're going to go back and look at what happened to Tanner real fast. We're just trying to get all that up out of the way. This could hurt Fitzwater because of the longer caution. Tanner is out of the event. Let's see what happened to him. They finally end the 31's day, currently in 26th. Actually, he wasn't even the cause of it. Something happened way up here with Joey Murphy, maybe? Yeah, Joey gets sideways, gets the wall, and Tanner and Eric Monaco and Cole Deaver. Scott Roush had really nowhere to go. Lights are still on this Dodge Charger pace car. Lights are out now. This right here is now the time for Zachary Fitzwater. Can he get Roush, their second Mud Summer National win? Last season they won with Gilbert. Green flag. Cody got a way better start. Shallow Bay Wood Brothers now driving into second place. This is Eric Rodriguez. Cody Lamas coming off that corner. Sliding it. 2 laps to go. 3 to go. But now he's got a hard charge in Eric Rodriguez, the winner from Indianapolis. Last season. Coming to 2 to go. Here could be the battle. The 48 versus the 21. 2 laps to go. And Eric's there. And the 16 has got a problem. He's towing his crew. Car feels like it's got a flat. Fitzwater feels like he's got a flat. White flag. Does Cody Lamas have enough? Is Eric Rodriguez going to dive it in turn 3? Coming to the checkered flag. Eric's giving it all he's got. But it's too little, too late. Cody Lamas will win the Mud Summer Nationals. Season 4. And that is Cody Lamas' first Sportsman Series win. Eric Rodriguez put up a good battle. Wow. Great race. I think Cody even got the fence right there off the final corner. That had been Cody's line the whole race, is to slide it up to the wall. He got him. And that was Eric Rodriguez. That was probably his best, one of his best laps of the event right there, running down Llamas. It's going to be a heartbreak on the 21 camp, knowing they did not win the Mud Summer Nationals, but they have nothing to be disappointed about. As you can hear Cody Llamas on the radio. His cars are angry, crashing each other, but we will get to see you guys next week at Auto Club Speedway. Here's your official standings. Llamas, Rodriguez, Cecily, Hawkins, Fitzwater. Got a fifth, even though feeling that the tire was going down. Eli Bright, Tim Brooks Jr., Oreo Pollard, DJ Curtis, Sam Curtis, Brandon Guns, Nick Kennedy, JT Bryant, Ryan Swan, TJ Hanley, Andy Thomas, Isaiah Monaco, Matt Haas, Isaac Jaco, Joey Murphy, Eric Monaco, Derek Edison, Scott Roush, Cole Deaver, Richard Johnson, Tanner Guns, Ash Curtis, Robert Pollard, Tayon Kennedy, and Emmanuel Harnett. That is your official standings for the Mud Summer National Season 4. We'll see you guys next week for the Auto Club 200 at Auto Club.